Hi, good evening. So welcome to BioLand Study Tour. Myself RSS Kalsaria. Today I am going to talk about diphtheria. So हम सबने diphtheria का नाम सुना है. So diphtheria. So nowadays this is a very common disease. Like it goes by one of the most famous bacteria that is Corynebacterium diphtheriae. आप सबने ये नाम सुना होगा. This bacteria possess some basic characteristics like that is gram positive, non motile, as well as aerobic bacteria, right? That may appear as a rod shape, but during growth, if we focus on it, if we observe it, it looks like a club shaped structure, right? If I talk about its epidemiology and pathology, so in which I can say that enters into your body, or we can say enter into in individuals via respiratory route, right? So simply we can say if I suffer by this bacteria or this bacterial infection, and if I coughing with a high frequency, or we can say a person that suffered by this infection that can transmit this bacteria to other individuals via airborne we can say air droplets, right? So these air droplets cause infection when it enters into the other individuals. कोई person के अंदर previous infection हुआ है, right? तो उसके अंदर जब second infection होगा, तो during second infection it provides you resistance, or we can say tolerance capacity during second infection. This disease is preventable, and we can say we have treatment nowadays for this disease. We have available antibiotics to treat this bacteria, but in pathology I can say okay, if I discuss pathology about this bacteria, so I can say simply when it enters to your body, right? We can say simply cause inflammation. But how it cause inflammation? So this bacteria possess one enzyme, you can note it down, one enzyme that is neuraminidase enzyme, and this neuraminidase enzyme has capacity to split N-acetyl neuraminic acid. And this N-acetylneuraminic acid is one of the component of glycoprotein that found on animal surface, animal cell surface, right? तो animal के animal cell है, या तो animal cell surface है, उसका ये एक component, animal cell surface के अंदर glycoproteins, और ये glycoproteins के अंदर एक component है, that is the N-acetylneuraminic acid. ये N-acetylneuraminic acid को split करता है. तो all in all क्या हुआ? Invasion हुआ, right? Animal cell surface में. और एनिमल सेल सरफेस में इन्वेजन हुआ, दैट लीड्स टू इन्फ्लेमेशन, और दिस इन्फ्लेमेशन लीड्स टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक लेशंस. तो ये लेशंस को हम बोलेंगे स्यूडो मेम्ब्रेन. तो दिस स्यूडो मेम्ब्रेन कंसिस्ट डैमेज होस्ट सेल एज वेल एज दिस पैथोजन. सो दिस स्यूडो मेम्ब्रेन समटाइम ब्लॉक एयर पैसेजेस, राइट? एंड दिस ब्लॉकेज ऑफ एयर पैसेजेस we can say leads to insufficiency of air, right? Individual or patient cannot get sufficient amount of oxygen, and that leads to damage of kidney, heart, right? So we can say myocarditis is one of the major symptoms that we can see in patients of Corynebacterium diphtheriae. When it shows, we can say infection at higher degree. Clear? So this is the one pathology that we can discuss in case of Corynebacterium diphtheriae. If I focus on second pathology in which certain species of Corynebacterium diphtheriae are lysogenized by bacteriophage beta, right? So normally क्या होता है उसको हम क्या कैसे समझ सकते हैं कि bacteriophage beta है उसका जो genetic material है that integrated into we can say this Corynebacterium diphtheriae. So this is known as lysogenized Corynebacterium diphtheriae, right? तो ये Corynebacterium diphtheriae जो lysogenized है, बराबर, that can produce we can say toxin or we can say toxic protein, right? That is diphtheria toxin. और ये diphtheria toxin है that is responsible to cause disease, right? And we can say that can inhibit eukaryotic protein synthesis in eukaryotic cell and kill the host cell, right? So this is how it damage, it can kill host cell. Tissue death होता है due to absorption of this toxin, and that leads to formation of pseudo membrane, right? तो tissue destruction हो गया, और ये tissue destruction के केस में क्या होगा, कि इट गोज इट इट क्रिएट्स पार्शल सफोकेशन ड्यू टू वी कैन से ब्लॉकेज ऑफ एयर पैसेज इन पेशेंट थ्रोट राइट. सो इन दैट केस वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड कि दैट गिव्स सिस्टमेटिक इन्फेक्शन राइट सिस्टमेटिक डिजीज डेवलपमेंट दैट लीड्स टू और दैट हार्म टू अदर ऑर्गन्स इन बॉडी लाइक वी कैन से किडनी हार्ट लिवर एटसेट्रा. Majority this disease we can see in childhood, right? So, but nowadays we have vaccine, right? That is a combination vaccine DTaP, that is DTaP or DTP vaccine, that is for three diseases, right? Diphtheria, tetanus, and pertussis, or we can say Bordetella pertussis, right? That cause whooping cough, right? So nowadays we have vaccine, or we can say DTP vaccine that we can give to create resistance or tolerance against these pathogens, or we can say treatment. But if I want to talk about diagnosis, so we have one laboratory culture technique, that is by nasal or nasal swab or throat swab, by using selective media or selective isolation media like blood agar, tellurite medium, right? Or we can use some other media that is much more specific for any bacterial diphtheria that we can use to isolate this bacteria, and we can culture it and we can detect okay, if patients suffered by this bacteria or not, right? And according to that we can apply, we can give antibiotics, so penicillin, gentamicin. These are common antibiotics that we can use to treat for any bacterial diphtheria infection. But again we will have to take suggestion from physician, right? So without taking suggestion from physician we cannot give treatment to patient, right? So I hope this is a very short and informative video for undergraduate students as well as postgraduate students. I hope this video is helpful to you for making notes on Corynebacterium diphtheria, or we can say disease diphtheria, right? So I hope you enjoy this video, and if you have any question regarding this you can ask, and if you want some more videos on some new topics you can message me or you can mail me on my email that I show you in description in last. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you everyone.